Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you slot antenna with great clarity. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be discussing about basics of slot antenna. After that, I'll explain you comparison of slot antenna with dipole antenna. After that, I'll explain you mechanical stability of slot antenna and dipole antenna. After that, I'll explain you calculation of impedance for slot antenna, and at last I'll explain you feeding mechanism of slot antenna. So let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of slot antenna. Slot antenna is simply opening cut in given metal sheet. If you observe the structure, see, in this metal sheet we have opening cut over here, that is slot, and length of this slot is lambda by 2. So slot antenna, that is simply opening cut in a given conductor sheet. See, slot antenna is complement antenna of dipole antenna. In my last video, I have explained you Babinet's principle. In that video, I have explained how Babinet principle functions, in which I have explained you how this dipole, that is complementary of slot. So one should know slot antenna, that is complementary structure of dipole. The reason is, here if you observe, see this slot, that is having length of lambda by 2. And if you have complementary structure of this, then we will be having metal which is having length of lambda by 2, that is simply dipole. So slot antenna is complement antenna of dipole antenna. Here slot antenna is having longer distance communication with respect to dipole antenna. The reason is, slot antenna is having better impedance matching with free space. So in this video, I'll be going to derive enhanced impedance of slot antenna, by which we'll get to know how it is having better radiation characteristics compared to dipole antenna. See, slot antenna is also having higher mechanical stability compared to dipole antenna. That even I'll explain you in this video itself. Now I'll be going to compare slot antenna with dipole antenna. Slot antenna is complement antenna of dipole antenna. That you can understand based on geometry. See, here we have slot antenna, in which we have opening cut over here, that is slot. Its length is lambda by 2. If you talk about complement structure of this, then here we will be having metal only, and that metal, that is having length of lambda by 2, means it is dipole antenna. So slot antenna is complement antenna of dipole antenna. Radiation of slot antenna is also complement of dipole antenna. Like, as if you have dipole antenna that is having vertical polarization, then slot antenna will be having horizontal polarization. Means you can say radiation of slot is also complement of dipole, right? See, slot antenna, that is perfectly conductor with respect to electric field. Means here conductivity, that is infinite. While if you talk about dipole, so that is perfectly conductor of magnetic field, means permeability, that will be infinite. The reason is, dipole and slot both are complement to each other. So here, if you say slot is perfectly conductor over here, then that will be perfectly conductor with respect to electric field, which gives you idea about conductivity is infinite. While dipole, if it is perfectly conductor, then it will be with respect to magnetic field, that will be having permeability, that is infinite. That's why in radiation also there will be complement, right? If you see the measurement results of slot and dipole antenna, then you will be observing few interesting conclusions. Like, as if I say polarization of slot antenna is linear, which is horizontal. If this design is having linear polarization, and as if it is horizontally polarized, in that case, same complement structure, which is dipole antenna, that will be having linear and vertical polarization. Here, electric fields of slot antenna and dipole antenna is almost similar, but it is complement to each other, right? Now I'll be explaining you how mechanical stability is there with slot antenna and dipole antenna. If you want higher mechanical stability of any antenna, then you will have to place given antenna horizontally. If you place antenna horizontally, then there will be less effect of wind on given antenna. So if you want higher stability of antenna, then you'll have to place antenna horizontally. If you have dipole antenna which is horizontally placed, in that case we will be having horizontal polarized signal. So here you can observe electric field is oscillating horizontally over here. And if you place slot antenna horizontally, then it will be having vertically polarized signal, means electric field that is varying vertically over here. So here what will happen? See, if you have EM waves which is horizontally polarized, what it means? Magnetic field oscillation will be vertical. As if magnetic field oscillation is vertical, then magnetic field absorption by Earth will be higher over here. The reason is Earth is having its own magnetic field. So as and when electromagnetic waves are traveling along the Earth, and as if magnetic field is oscillating like this, then there will be higher attenuation of EM waves. So with dipole antenna, if it is horizontally placed, then there will be higher attenuation of EM waves. While with slot antenna, if you place it horizontally, then magnetic field will be oscillating horizontally and electric field will be oscillating vertically, which is having lower attenuation. So with slot antenna, you can orient it horizontally, which is having higher mechanical stability, right? Now I'll explain you impedance calculation of slot antenna. Impedance of slot antenna is way better compared to the impedance of dipole antenna. The reason is impedance of slot antenna is having better impedance matching with free space. That even I'll be deriving in this video. So to derive impedance of slot antenna, one should know Babinet's principle. So as per Babinet's principle, one can say impedance of slot antenna into complementary structure impedance is equals to eta square by 4. Here one should know, see this ZS, that is impedance of slot antenna. Here ZCS, that is impedance of complementary structure of slot antenna. Complementary structure of slot antenna, that is dipole antenna. So ZCS, that is impedance of dipole. And impedance of dipole antenna is how much? It is 73 plus J42.50. Usually we consider real component only, but I'll be calculating this impedance precisely. Here eta is free space impedance and value of eta, that is 120 pi, and approximated value can be written as 377 ohm if you do this in calculator, right? We are dealt with to identify impedance of slot antenna. So if you want to calculate impedance of slot antenna, that is ZS, that will be 1 by ZCS into eta square by 4. If you want precise calculation, then you can place ZCS, that as 73 plus J42.5 into eta square, that is 377 square divided by 4. Just do this calculation in calculator. Let me check my answer. That is around 363 minus J211. Approximated value, that is 366 minus J211, right? And if you want only real component, then for real component only, you need to consider ZCS, that is equals to 73 ohm. So in that situation, you will be getting ZS, that will be 1 by ZCS into eta square by 4, where ZCS that is 73, eta is 377 square by 4. Just do this calculation in calculator, you will be getting 486 ohm, right? So here if you observe impedance of slot antenna in terms of real value, it is 486 ohms. Impedance of free space, that is 377 ohm, right? And impedance of this dipole antenna, that is 73. So which one is nearer to 377? But obviously slot antenna impedance, that's why one can say slot antenna impedance is having better impedance matching with free space compared to dipole antenna, right? That's why slot antenna will radiate higher power compared to dipole antenna. Why? The reason is slot antenna is having higher impedance matching with free space compared to dipole antenna, right? Now I'll explain you feeding techniques of slot antenna. Here I'll be explaining you three different types of feeding with slot antenna. See, first feeding mechanism is two wire feeding of slot. Here we have slot in which if you want to provide two wire feeding, then you will have to take middle of these two edges and you will have to connect two wires like this. So you can observe we have two wires by which we are applying feeding to this given slot antenna, where see this much spacing, that is lambda by 4, that is half of lambda by 2. So exactly at the middle of these two edges, we can apply these two wires for feeding using two wire feeding technique. See, in next feeding technique, we will be having coaxial feeding. In coaxial feeding, there will be inner conductor. So inner conductor that we will be connecting somewhere over here. See, this is inner conductor, right? That we will be connecting somewhere over here, and outer conductor that one can connect over here, or it can be connected anywhere on this metal sheet. Here, for a proper impedance matching, we need to locate this inner conductor on this edge, right? There is no exact position that I can directly say, like over here you should be connecting it. That you need to tune by some softwares, like you can use HFSS or CST software to identify exact location of this inner conductor over here. But in general, you can say this is how we will be connecting this coaxial probe to feed this slot antenna, right? Now see, third mechanism, that is waveguide feeding. Waveguide feeding, that is quite easy. You see, here you will be having waveguide, that will be rectangular waveguide, right? So here we have rectangular waveguide that you can observe, and by this rectangular waveguide, one can feed this slot antenna. So by connecting waveguide over here with this slot, we can have feeding of slot antenna. That is how different feeding mechanisms are there. Even few more feeding mechanisms are there, but these are three popular feeding mechanisms that we use it with slot antenna. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.